Let's now discuss some facts about variation of binding energy per nucleon with mass number. This is the graph which shows the binding energy per nucleon in million electron volt per nucleon with the mass number of various elements in the periodic table. Here we can see that for lightweight elements, the binding energy rapidly increases, and for iron, which is having the mass number 56, the binding energy approaches to the maximum value, which is 8.8 million electron volt, and that is the maximum binding energy per nucleon among all the elements. So we can say the nucleus of element iron is the most stable nucleus in the whole periodic table. And for all the elements, if we take out the average binding energy per nucleon for all the elements comes approximately 7.7 million electron volt. And for heavyweight elements, we can see the downfall in binding energy per nucleon is gradual, not as rapid as it was increase in lower weight nuclei. And there are some fluctuations which are observed in binding energy per nucleon values for very low weight elements. And here we can see this is helium 4, then carbon 12 and oxygen 16. Their binding energy is more compared to their neighbors, and this is assumed because of the pairing of opposite spin nucleons and the nucleon energy levels within the nuclei, which right now is beyond the scope of these lectures. I will take it up in advanced lectures. So, here by observation we see these elements helium, carbon and oxygen are more stable nuclei compared to their neighboring elements. So, these are some facts you must be aware about the binding energy per nucleon of an element, which gives us the idea about the stability of various nuclei which are found in nature. The applications of this variation we are going to take up in the next topic of nuclear reactions, where this curve is going to play an important role in analysis of various nuclear reactions and the energy produced in the reactions.